Hello and welcome to part 7 of the Jacaranda Crochet Along. We're going to continue with round 61. We're going to use color A for this. We're going to start in a chain 3 space at any corner. We're only going to work into the chain 3 spaces. We're not going to work into the single crochets of the previous round. Into that chain 3 space at the corner, we're going to make 4 double crochets. Chain 3 and 4 double crochets. So make a standing double crochet like this and make 3 more, 2, 3 and 4, chain 3, that you could be calling your new corner space. Let me just get some more yarn. Tangled here. There we go. After your chain 3, we're going to make 4 more double crochets into the same corner. 1, 2, 3, and 4. That's the corner made. Chain 1. Skip the next chain 3 space. And in the next chain 3 space, so skipping this one, working into this one, we're going to do almost exactly the same. We're going to make 4 double crochets. 2, 3, 4. Chain 2, so not chain 3, chain 2, and 4 more double crochets. 2, 3, and 4. Like this. Like little shells, you could call them. That is all that the repeat is about. So chain 1, skipping the next chain 3 space, working into the next. Make 4 double crochets. So this is 2, 3, 4, chain 2, and 1, 2, 3, and 4 double crochets. That's all there is to this round. It's quite relaxing and easy. So basically, I'll summarize it for you one last time. In the corners, we make 4 double crochets, chain 3, 4 double crochets. And between every group, we make a chain 1. And then in every other space, so we're skipping a space every time, we're making 4 double crochets, chain 2, 4 double crochets. That's all you're going to do this round. Do this all the way around. Close with a slip stitch on your first stitch, and then I'll see you for round 62. Round 62. This round we're going to work into 2 different rounds. We're going to work in the previous round, which is round 61, and we're also going to work in round 59, which in my case is the purple, the dark purple. So you can just count backwards. It was 61, 60, 59. So these stitches we're going to use as well. And we're going to start in the chain 3 space at the corner and make 2 half double crochets. Start with a standing half double crochet. Make one more. Snatching my yarn. There we go. So start with 2 half double crochets, chain 2, and 2 more half double crochets. And that's corner made. Snatch my yarn again. Let me see. There we go. Around the next two double crochets, we're going to make a back post half double crochet. So from the back to the front, around the stitch, make a back post half double crochet. And also around the second one, also a back post half double crochet, like this. Back post double crochet around the next two double crochets. So from the back to the front as well, but only this time make a double crochet. And again, so two in a row, like this. This is what it should look like. Now we're going to work in round 59. And we're going to work a popcorn into the second free stitch of round 59. So if you look to work, this is the first free stitch of round 59. This is the second, this is the third. We're going to work into the second stitch. We're going to make a popcorn in that stitch. And we're going to work in front of all this. So just work in front of your work, which makes a lot of sense, of course. And just make a popcorn into that free stitch. So that's five double crochets that we need to make. This is four and five. Remove your hook and finish your popcorn as you always do with a chain one, like this. After your popcorn, we're going to go back to the current round, which is round 61. And we're going to skip this chain one space that we made, this one. And we're going to make a back post double crochet into the first two double crochets of this shell. So we're going to go from the back to the front and make double crochet into the first two double crochets of that shell, like this, and a back post half double crochet into the next two stitches. So same thing, only with a half double crochet into the next, around the next two double crochets. We're going to skip the chain two space, and we're going to mirror what we just did. We're going to make back post half double crochet into the next stitch, around the next stitch, and also around the second double crochet of that half, and a back post double crochet around the last two of that shell, like this. As you can see, it's a little bit fiddly, but it's not hard, and it looks amazing. It really looks so nice with the popcorn and all the back post stitches. I'll show you again, and then I'm sure you can do it by yourself, because this is the repeat. This is all we're going to do this round. We're going to make a skipping again this space for now. Making a popcorn into the second free stitch of round 59. So again, this is the first and this is the second. Working in front of your work, make five double crochets to make a popcorn. This is two, three, four, and five. And finish your popcorn as usual, like this. Skipping the chain one, work a double crochet in around the first stitch, back post half double crochet, and also in the second one, a half double crochet in the next one, back post half double crochet, and a back post half double crochet as well in the one next to it. Skipping the chain two space, back post half double crochet into the next stitch and in the next one as well, and a back post double crochet into the next two stitches like this. And then popcorn and so forth. So I'll tell you quickly about the logic behind it, so you don't need to look at the pattern all the time. Basically, you're making, of course, a popcorn into that middle stitch, which makes sense. We're not going to make any chain space or anything in this round. We're just going to make half double back post, half double crochets, and back post double crochets. And you can always remember that when you're near the top, at the two stitches near the top, you need to make back post half double crochets because they need to be shorter. And because these need to be longer, you need to make on the two outer ones, the ones that aren't near to the top or that are near to the popcorns, you need to make back post double crochets. So that's how you could remember doing this round. As you can see, I really love how this round looks. It's going to be take you a while to make them because it's really quite a lot of stitches that you're making, but the result is gorgeous. Just keep going until you're at the end. Finish with a slip stitch and I will see you for round 63. Round 63. We're going to start in the chain two space at the corner. So starting into this chain two space over here. And we're going to make in that space a new corner, which exists of a standing half double crochet. There we go. Another half double crochet, so two half double crochet, chain two, and two half double crochet. So that's our new corner made. In the next three stitches, we're making a half double crochet as well. And don't forget to work into that first stitch as well, which is a little bit hidden. It's this first of the two half double crochets of the previous round. So work a half double crochet into that hidden stitch. And a half double crochet in the next two stitches as well. Like this. Then we're making a double crochet into the next three stitches. One, two, and three. I'm going to skip the popcorn. So this is supposedly the stitch of the popcorn. I'm going to make a double crochet into the next two double crochets. So into that next double crochet after the popcorn, make a double crochet, and into the one after it as well, half double crochet into the next four stitches, so basically into the next four half double crochets of the previous round. That's how you can check your work. One, two, three, and four. Double crochet into the next two stitches, which are the next two double crochet of the previous round. One, two, and that was our first repeat. I'll show you again. So, again, from the beginning, this repeat, skipping the popcorn, just this one, double crochet into the next two double crochets or next two stitches, one, two, half double crochet into the next four stitches, which are the half double crochet of the previous round, two, three, four, and a double crochet into the next two stitches, which are the last two double crochets of the previous round. So, as you can see, this round is quite easy, quite relaxing as well. And it's a little bit to straighten out your work again, because it was nice and wavy the previous round, as you can see. And the only little bit of a difference that we're going to do is in the corners, and also that's very easy. So just take out the pattern, you should be fine. Do this all the way around, and I'll see you for round 64. Round 64. In this round, we're going to work in three different rounds. Let's just take a moment to make sure that we know what rounds we're working in. This is the current round, so what's mentioned as to be the current round. This is round 63. The lilac color is around 63. I'm confusing myself. This is the current round, which is round 63. That's what is going to be called the current round in the pattern. The lila color is round 62. And we're also working 61, which is the white. So 61 is the white. 62 is the one with the popcorns, and 63 is the current round. Okay, I'll show you where we will start. We're going to start into the double crochet before the first popcorn. So this is the first popcorn, and we're going to start into that double crochet before that popcorn of the current round and make a single crochet into that double crochet like this. As you can see, I've made a single crochet into that double crochet right before that first popcorn. Into round 62, which is the lila color, we're going to make a front post treble, which is three times over, which I just did, around the popcorn. So from the front, around the popcorn to the back, pick up your yarn and finish your treble as usual, like this. There you go. We're going back to the current round, which is round 63. We're going to skip the stitch behind this front post treble, behind that popcorn, which is this stitch. So this stitch we're skipping. And we're making a single crochet into the next three stitches. So this is 1, 2, and 3. Now we're going to round 61, which we said was the white, and we're making a double crochet into the chain 2 space. And this is the chain 2 space I'm talking about. This is the chain 2 space. For now, it was, until now, it was unworked. We're making a double crochet in that chain 2 space. Back to the current round, skipping again that stitch behind the double crochet that we just made, and make a single crochet into the next stitch and also in the two after. So in the next three stitches, making a single crochet. This seems like a lot, but it really isn't. I'll show you again. It really isn't that hard to show. I'll show you again what we're going to do. So we're going to work in round 62, make a front post treble, yarn three times over. No, sorry, yarn two times over. I made a mistake here. That should be yarn two times over. I'm just going to get my work out. This is a treble, not a double treble. It's good that I checking myself, so I just prog my work. This is a double, this is a treble. So we're making a front post treble, which is twice over, not three times over, around the popcorn, and finish like a normal treble. Skipping that stitch behind the treble, front post treble, make a single crochet into the next three stitches, two and three, double crochet into this chain two space that we were talking about before, like this, make a double crochet, skipping that stitch behind the double crochet, make a single crochet into the next three stitches, like this. Show you one last time. Yarn twice over for the front post treble around the popcorn, like this. Finish your treble as usual. Skip that stitch behind your treble and make a single crochet into the next three stitches. Double crochet into the chain space of round 61, like this. And skipping this stitch again, that's behind the double crochet, make a single crochet into the next three stitches. That's all there is to this repeat. You can see it makes a nice finishing to the previous rounds. Makes this nice and pointy as well. And this is what we're going to do all along the side. Of course, when we get to the corner, I'll show you what to do in there. So I'll just finish this side and I'll come back to you to show you how we're going to do the corners. Continuing round 64, as you can see, I finished this whole side and I'm almost at the corner. And I'll show you how to finish the rest of this whole round. Again, we're skipping this this stitch that's behind the treble crochet and making three single crochets into the next three stitches. So exactly like we did before. Make a double crochet into the, make a double crochet into the fourth double crochet of the shell. This is the last double crochet right before the corner of round 61. So we're making this into this double crochet, like this. So we have four double crochets here. Going to the last double crochet, make a double crochet in there. So it's basically like we used, like we did before with the chain two spaces, but now we're doing it into the double crochet. We're going to skip the stitch behind this double crochet again, like we also used to do until now. The stitch we're going to skip and make a single crochet into the next three stitches. One, two, and three. Into the chain two space at the corner, we're making three single crochets as well. One, two, and three. And this is your new corner. Skip that first hidden stitch, which is the stitch of this double crochet. Into the next three stitches, make a single crochet. One, two, and three. Double crochet into the first double crochet of these four double crochets, like we did also on the other side. Skip the stitch behind it and a single crochet into the next three stitches. Now we've arrived at exactly the same point that we started, which is the first or the last double crochet right before this popcorn. Do this all the way around. Close with a slip stitch on your first stitch and I'll see you for round 65. Round 65. We're going to continue with the same color yarn, only we're starting at a different place that we ended, so that's why you had to cut your yarn, or I had to cut my yarn. And I'm going to also start in even a different place than the pattern calls for. Pattern calls for starting at the second single crochet after those three single crochets in the corner. It doesn't really, of course, really matter where you start in any pattern, because it you're going to do it all the way around anyway. So I'm just going to start right before the corner, so I can show you the corner and also the repeat all in one video. But of course, if you want to start like the pattern, that's also fine. So don't worry about that. What we're going to do is we're going to make a front post single crochet. Yes, we're going to make a front post single crochet around this treble, which is the one, the last treble before the corner. Just start with a front post treble around, a front post single crochet around that treble, like this. That's how we're going to start our way to the corner. We're going to chain three. We're going to skip the next stitch, which is this single crochet. We're going to make a double crochet into the next two stitches. So skipping this single crochet, going to the next single crochet, make a double crochet, and in the next one as well. Chain one, skip the next stitch, which is this double crochet that was made into round 61, and make a double crochet into the next two stitches. One, two, chain one, skip the next stitch, and make a double crochet into the next stitch, which is the last stitch right before the middle, it's the one before the middle, a single crochet in the corner. Make a double crochet in there. In the center single crochet at the corner, we're going to make two double crochet, chain two and two double crochet. So this is the first double crochet, this is the second double crochet, this one, this is the third double crochet. We're working into the second double crochet, a second single crochet, sorry. I'm making two double crochets in there. Chain two and two more double crochets into the same corner or same stitch, like this. And of course, in this case, your corner is your center single crochet. After you made this corner, you're going to make a double crochet into the next stitch, which is the third single crochet that you made into the chain two space. This one. Make a double crochet, like this. Chain one. Skip this next stitch. And make a double crochet into the stitch after that. This is where the pattern starts. So if you start it along with what the pattern says, and this is your starting point. And also make a double crochet into the stitch right after that. Chain one. This is our repeat. So starting with the chain one. Skip this double crochet made into round 61. And make a double crochet into the next two stitches. So, skipping this stitch, working into this stitch, make double crochet, also into the next stitch as well, like this. Chain three, skip the next stitch, this stitch, and make a front post single crochet around the front post treble. So just like we did in the other side, make a front post single crochet around that stitch, like this. chain 3, 1, 2, 3, skip the next single crochet, next stitch, and make a double crochet into the next two stitches. 1 and 2, like this. This is a complete repeat that I just did, this bit. I'll show you one more time. Chain 1, skip the next stitch, which is this double crochet made into round 61, and make a double crochet into the next two stitches. 1, I'm snagging my yarn. 2 double crochets. Chain 3, skip this next stitch, make a front post single crochet around the treble, front post treble of the previous round. Chain 3, skip this first single crochet and make a double crochet into the next two stitches. Again, we finished a repeat. So this is the repeat of this round. Basically, you're making these chain 3 spaces to bridge the height difference of the front post single crochet and those double crochets, so it doesn't pull. Make your stitches all the way around until you get to the beginning stitch, and close with a slip stitch on your first stitch. And then I'll see you for round 66. Round 66. I'm going to start in a chain 2 space in a corner. So any of these spaces. And we're going to start with a single crochet into that corner. Chain 2. And another single crochet into that same chain 2 space, like this. That's your new corner made. Into the next 3 double crochet, we're going to make a single crochet. So get into that first double crochet, which might be a bit hidden. Make a double single crochet, and also in the second and the third, like this. We're going to make a treble into the skipped stitch of round 64. So just go into that stitch and make a treble in there in front of your work, like this. After this treble, going to skip this chain 1 space and make a single crochet into the next 2 double crochet. 1 and 2. Now we're ready for our repeat, and we're going to make a front post treble around this double crochet. So the double crochet from round in that post made into the chain space of round 61. Make a front post treble around it, like this. Skip the chain 1 space behind the front post treble. Make a single crochet into the next 2 double crochet. Now we're going to make an X stitch, which is basically an X that you're making into work. And I'll show you how to do that. For this X, we are going to make a treble, a chain 1, and another treble. And I'll show you how to do that. We're going to use this skipped stitch and also this skipped stitch. Instead of working into this skipped stitch first, we're going to skip that for now and go to the second skipped stitch. Work in front of your work and work a very normal treble like you would at any other time. Chain 1. Get ready for another treble. You go back to your work, to that first skipped stitch, So get your needle into that stitch in front of your work again and finish your treble again as usual. Oh, there you go. This is your first X stitch made, and you will see the real X when we do the next couple of stitches. After this X stitch, I'm going to skip all of this from round 65, make a single crochet into the next two double crochet, and I'll show you how the X will look. This is the X that we're going for. As you can see, it's basically two crossed trebles into two skipped stitches, only except normally you would work into this stitch first and then into this one, worked first in here and first in there. That creates that X. I'll show you one more time. It's quite an easy round once you get the hang of this one. So we're going to make a front post treble around this double crochet again, just like we did before. A treble. Front post treble, rather, because you're doing it around the stitch. Single crochet into the next two double crochets. Going to make another X into that second skipped stitch. Make a treble. Chain one. Going back to that first skipped stitch. In front of your work, make a second treble to form an X, like this. Single crochet to make your X pop up, like this. As you can see, you're making these crossed stitches to create little X's. This we're going to do all the way around. In the corners, you also know what to do. I just showed you. I get the pattern as well because it's a little bit wordy this round. But as I said, once you get the hang of it, it should be easy. Do this all the way around until you're at the last stitch. Close with a slip stitch, and I'll see you for the last round of part 7. Round 67. The pattern calls for starting in the first double crochet after a corner of round 65. But I will start right before the corner so I can also show you how to do the corner. Of course, you're free to start at the same place I start, or you can start like the pattern tells you to. What we're going to do in this round is we're going to make lots of front post double crochet two togethers. And I'll show you how to do that. So we're starting in the one to last double crochet of round 65 right before a corner. So you have this last one. This is the one right before that. And we're going to make a front post double crochet two together around that double crochet and also the one right before the corner. Like this. Show you again several times how to make a front post double crochet two together. To make your corner, we're just going to make a chain four. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this is just to bridge all of this corner. On the other side, we're mirroring what we did here. So make a front post double crochet two together. That means yarn over around the first double crochet, pull through once, two loops on your hook, yarn over, go to next stitch, pull through two loops, and then pull through three loops. That's just to remind you what a front post double crochet two together is. After your first front post double crochet two together of this side, we're going to make a single crochet into the single crochet just before this double crochet. So there's a double crochet here. This is the double crochet. Make a single crochet into that single crochet right before it. Chain two. And this is the start of our repeat. Front post, double crochet two together around the next two double crochets of round 65. So just make a front post, double crochet two together around those two double crochets, like this. Chain one, front post, double crochet two together again around the next two, so skipping all of this, like this. And then we're making a chain one, and in between the two trebles of this X, where we made a chain one, we're going to make three single crochets. This one, this is two, and this is three, like this. I'll show you this repeat again. Chain one, that's actually still part of the first repeat. Front post, double crochet two together around these two double crochets. Chain one, yes. Front post, double crochet two together around the next two double crochets, like this. Chain one, in that chain space in between the two trebles, make three single crochets, and chain one, like this. This is what you're wanting to do. I think you can do the rest yourself. Go all the way around, make all your stitches, close with a slip stitch on your first stitch, and after you're done, you're actually done with part seven. So we're way over half of the Jacaranda crochet along. I hope you had a good time making it. I hope you had a lot of use for this video as well, and hopefully I'll see you for part eight. And have a great crochet day.